know that was definitely a very interesting tip that you gave our audience today. What are some other things that they may consider even with their physical activity?
Well, you got to get your butt up off the couch and get moving. That's necessary. Mm-hmm. And you've got to see movement, physical activity, as an obligation and not a convenience. A lot of times we think of it as, well, you know, it's not convenient. I would say, if you got 10 minutes, I can change your life. You give me 10 minutes, because you can do this thing 10 minutes at a time. If you don't have an hour or a half hour to go to the gym or to go work out in some place in a concentrated block of time, 10 minutes, I'd say two or three times a day. You've already put in 20 or 30 minutes. The other thing is, if you have carpet on your floor, there's no reason you can't do lunges or squats with the back and cleaning while you're carpeting. The point is that we have to, you know, use every opportunity doing those things that we have to do and those things that we enjoy doing to burn calories. Okay. And it's possible.
Okay. Recently you were at the Congressional Black Caucus Legislative Conference, mm-hmm. and you were on an obesity panel with, you know, women like Star Jones.
Yes.
So who were some of the other people that were on the panel?
Oh, Dr. Tricia Rose, professor and anthropologist at Brown University, just a whole myriad of just powerful and engaging women. I was very honored to be there on behalf of Congressman Meeks from New York, and the panel was called When Fat, F-A-T, is No Longer Fat, P-H-A-T. So I think we made a huge connection with women present and families present. I'm honored to, you know, have been able to serve in this way. Mm-hmm. And as I said before, this is the reason I get up in the morning. I do this as a part
true
of my
passion.
Life.
True passion. So I know that you have a little bit more fellowship to do here.
Got a lot more.
So we don't want to hold you back, but it's been a really huge pleasure and honor to spend this time with you in the interview, just listening to you speak today, just encouraging sisters, encouraging our new national president. I'm encouraging people to get up, stop waiting, lead with love. You
yes.
know, I have sometimes just overflowing a lot of times when you come to these conventions and just listening to our sisters. So I truly appreciate you for being here today.
It's my absolute honor. It's a privilege for me to do this. So thank you so much for having me.
And you look
so
amazing.
Proud of you.
You look amazing. I don't want to put your age out there, but I know that you have been in swing for quite some time. But
yeah, since like 1907. Yeah.
But you look amazing. I mean, I wish you all could just, I don't know if you want to just kind of slowly get up, but I mean, you've probably seen the pictures of Dr. Rowe.
No,
this
there,
sister,
there would be no butt shots.
This sister looks amazing. So just seeing you in this shape at your age, that is truly encouraging to me and other sisters who need to get up and stop waiting.
I appreciate it.
Hola, my sister.
Hola to you.
Hola, and we are out. So if you're not here, you are really missing out. You need to get on down to Hunt Valley, Maryland, so you can come hang out and fellowship at the 2012 National Convention. Hola, my sisters, and goodbye to our watchers. Boop.